Okay, finally, to add the third part, I'm going to play a harpsichord. And a harpsichord has a sound like this. Well, that's one of the sounds, and it's an instrument that came before a piano. Looks a little like a piano, and it's in the shape of a harp. At least, if you can recall what a concert piano looks like, a concert piano looks like this. And the keys go along here. Well, a harpsichord is shaped kind of like that, in that it looks more like that, and the keys go along here. And the reason is, on both instruments, the shorter strings are to the right, and the longer strings over here are to the left. All right, so this is the shape of a piano, and the shorter strings are over here, the higher pitches over here, and the longer strings would be over here. Piano is very different than a harpsichord, although they're both operated by keys. Now, this would be an electric piano, and it's really just a trigger. The keyboard is a trigger that creates mechanically, in this case electronically, creates a tone, and you can create the tone by either plucking the string like a guitar, and a harpsichord actually does that. It plucks with a quill, whereas a piano hits with a hammer. Pianos didn't come along until much later, until the time of Mozart and Beethoven. Anyway, let's go ahead, and I'm going to do rather poor job on this keyboard with this, but regardless of the mistakes, at least get an idea of what a harpsichord sounds like. I was going to do it on guitar, but then I decided that we would go ahead and be authentic and use a harpsichord. Harpsichords were the number one continual instruments in the Baroque period. Now we'll go ahead and we'll listen to the click track. I'll go ahead and put on the click track anyway. Okay, so turn this off. We can play the whole thing now and see what it sounds like again from the beginning. Let's take the click off. Now here's a picture of the recording over here on the computer. And this is a recording program that I have. And here's the transport window. This actually turns it on. Let's turn that click off. So you see, it's metered, meaning it's in 3 or 4 or 2 time. In this case, it's in 3, 4. You heard the click track, clicking out time. So it's an aria. And this would have taken place if it had been in an opera, which it wasn't, but the music is entirely appropriate for an opera. This would have taken place where the action stops and the singer would sing about her feelings. And during the Baroque period, composers adopted a practice known as the doctrine of ethos. And it harks back to the Greeks, and the Greeks believed that music could touch people inside. Music could actually change one's mood. It could alter one's feelings. It could even, according to some philosophers, Plato, they believed that if you listen to the right kind of music, you could be the right kind of person. If you listen to the wrong kind of music, it would affect you negatively. And this is a fascinating subject. What do you think? But composers believed that during appropriate moments in the music, that it would be entirely up to him to create the mood. Of course, every single piece had its own mood. When we get to the classical period, each piece, if you had a longer piece of music, you could change the mood within that single piece. So anyway, let me save this, and I want to give you an example of music and the mood. Let's listen to this one. Hear the lute? You'll notice some of the things I wrote up on the board here. Listen to the ground bass. This is in the minor key, F sharp again. Sound complete? It sounded complete to me. Let's do it again. This is what a ground bass is, and the whole piece is based on it. In fact, listen, it starts on it. It's very, very soft. There it is. Just that one loop. Again. It's kind of like a verse to a song, verse, chorus, except there's just one unifying structure, that ground bass, or ground. And the ground is a descending line. Da, 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 da. And then a cadence, which means an ending. Da, 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 da. Knocked it down, and it continues down. The whole piece is structured on that form, on that basic scaffold. And then, of course, the other lutes and the strings play the chords, play the harmony. In this case, the continuo is stringed instruments. I don't hear a harpsichord. And the strings following along. This is an aria, and it's metered in 3, 2, 1, 2. 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And the descending motive, according to the doctrine of ethos, the descending motive was very popular for portraying death. And of course, what are the lyrics? She's lost her lover. She's lost will to live. She's in a pretty sad situation. She just wants to be laid in the earth. And she doesn't want to trouble anybody. And so she's going to her grave with a lament, Dido's lament. In the next lecture, we'll talk about some instrumental music and another cantata, which would be a vocal piece, a large church vocal piece.